Harvey, all the way from Western Australia. He's in True Blue Lane number 4.
Thank you, PC, as we see boats coming down to face the official starter. This is going to be a cracker, the Clyde Lewis. Heat number 1 for 6-litre boats. Waiting for the flag to drop. Bang, goes the call. We are racing, and it is going to be throw a blanket over them. Stuff as they come in into turn number 1. Shenanigans, rude as ever, going True Blue. Tip into the port, turn to the bottom end of the course, and it is on like Donkey Kong here. True Blue once wide. He cost himself a lot of ground there. He needs to gather it back together now and tighten the whole show up. But Shenanigans, it is the silver rocket ship, the silver bullet, the Shenanigans. Chris Pugsley with the bit between the teeth now as he fires down the front straight away. Mark Edruder in the Rooters into second place. Then it's Craig Stoner in the Abaco round the outside. He runs a little bit wide as well. True Blue now drops into, goes from pole number 1 out to about pole number 6 as they fire up the back chute, PC.
Yeah, Chris Pugsley's doing it beautifully here as he enters the front straight here. He'll see the yellow flag, knowing one lap to go. Rudis will also say, oh, lighting high out of the water there now is Rudis. Abba goes into third, True Blue's out of the picture there in fourth place. Pugsley now hammers it around the corner, heads back up into the wind. It looks like Chris Pugsley's going to do this one with a little bit of ease. But Pugsley, the true champion, is pushing hard. Oh, Pugsley's getting very high into the breeze itself. Rudis in the second position. It's a little bit about pole position and time here. I know Chris Pugsley wants the inside line now, Bisho, as he heads down the straight. He sees the jacket flag and takes a great win. Chris Pugsley, ladies and gentlemen, here comes Rudis now into second position. Great drive by Mark Edruder. He's done a fantastic job. Abigail driven by Craig Stoner. Fantastic. And True Blue, Paul Harvey will round out the field here in heat number 1.
Oh, heat number 1 done and dusted. I'll tell you what, Harvey ran a little bit wide on that first corner. He really struggled to gather it back together after that. He's got the pace. But who's got the pace to beat Chris Pugsley in the Shenanigans? He is a rocket ship here at Melton this weekend, as always. And the silver bullet gets the job done